वेलकम ऑल. वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आर नेक्स्ट लेसन, आर सिक्स लेसन, दैट इज मेजरमेंट ऑफ फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज. कैन एनीवन टेल मी व्हाट इज मीन बाय फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज? येस, फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज मीन्स व्हाट? द फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज इज नॉर्मली एक्सप्रेस इन द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ अ यूनिट एंड अ नंबर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, 5 kg, 2 grams, 30 kilo, 30 cm. सो इन टर्म्स ऑफ दिस एंड इट कैन बी मेजर्ड. So physical quantities are those quantities which can be measured. Now we are going to study more about these physical quantities in this lesson. Okay, how are the various articles and materials shown in the picture measured? Now tell me, these brinjals, you can see they are measured in kgs. A thread, which is it can be measured in meters. You can see the vegetables, it can be measured in particularly by the bunches itself. Water or the milk can be measured in liters. Gold is measured in grams or kg, and these are the ropes, like, or the cloth is also measured in meters. So physical quantities means what? So physical quantities, in day to day life we measure many things, such as weight of the fruits, vegetables, food grains, temperature of the body and some other liquids. Normally we come in the contact of this particular units, this particular quantities. For example, if you go in one of the shop, when you are asking for potatoes, you are going to ask 2 kg potatoes, or you are, if you want milk, you are going to say 2 liter milk, whatever it is. So you are using this number and a unit together, and we are normally coming in contact of these physical quantities. So quantities such as mass, weight, distance, speed, temperature, volume are called as physical quantities. So quantities such as mass, weight, distance, speed, temperature, volume are said to be as physical quantities. Why physical quantities? Because this can be measured. A value and a unit is used to express the magnitude of the physical quantity. What is mean by magnitude? Yes, magnitude can be denoted, or magnitude can be shown in a form of a value and a unit. I have just now told you 5 kilometers. So 5 is a value over here and kilometer is the unit over here. Magnitude means a size of it. Magnitude means what it actually contains. Okay. For example, Swarali walked 2 kilometers every day. Right now in this example, 2 is the value and kilometer is the unit used to express this. Now, your distance which has been given, she is walking for 2 kilometers. So this is a unit which is used to express the magnitude of the distance, which is a physical quantity. Now one thing you should remember, these quantities are later divided into two main types. One is the scalar quantity and another one is the vector quantity. What is mean by scalar quantity? We will see first. A quantity that can be completely expressed by its magnitude alone is called as scalar quantity. For example, means only magnitude means only size. For example, 5 kilometers which is there, I'm only going to say 5. I'm not going to use the unit which is remaining to it. So the size actually of it. So the quantity which can be completely expressed by its magnitude alone is called as scalar quantity. For example, only magnitude, that is the value, a value with a unit, is used to express the quantities such as the length, the breadth, the area, a mass, a temperature, density, time, work, etc. Okay, so for example, you are going to measure the fever, which is 101 Fahrenheit. Fahrenheit over here is a unit. So what they have told, whatever the size is present, they are going to express in this scalar quantity. So what is the vector quantity present here? Now, the quantity which can be expressed in magnitude also and the direction also. The quantity which can be expressed in the terms of magnitude also and the direction also is said to be as a vector quantity. Now, displacement. Now, you just tell me, displacement means what? You are changing one place. You are changing your place from A to B. If you are going from A to B, you are changing your place. But while changing your place, you are going in a certain direction. While changing your place, you are going in a certain direction. So your direction is mentioned and you are traveling a certain distance, that is 5 kilometer. So here this displacement is coming a vector quantity. Velocity. Velocity means what? The change in displacement in a particular time, whatever you do. These all are vectors quantities. For example, displacement of 20 kilometers towards north. Where you are going 20 kilometers? Yes, you are going 20 kilometers towards north. Now, if it was only 20 kilometers, then it was a scalar quantity. But right now, 20 kilometers, where you are going? You are going towards north, so it is a vector quantity. Aeroplane flying at the velocity of 500 kilometers per hour towards Mumbai. Now, where that aeroplane is going? It is going towards Mumbai. So, your direction is also present. 500 kilometers per hour it was given, then it was only scalar. But now it is, they are telling you 500 km per hour towards Mumbai, your direction is also specified, that's why it is vector quantity. So clear these ideas about scalar quantities and the vector quantities. Now we will see what is meant by mass. So mass, the amount of matter present in a substance is called as mass. For example, if you take a marker or if you take the pen. Pen consists of a cap, the outside covering, the refill, two inlets, okay. So what the pen consists of? Pen consists of this various thing. So whatever is present in that pen is coming together and forming its mass. Matter has natural tendency to resist the change in its state. For example, if you take any of the substance, if you take a small duster or if you take the eraser, it will not change its state unless and until you are going to give or you are going to heat it or cool it. Mass is the qualitative measure of the inertia of an object. The larger the mass, the greater will be the inertia of it. Mass is a scalar quantity. Why mass is a scalar quantity? Here, for example, I have told you, a pen consists of a refill, a cap, the outside cover of it, two side inlets which are covering that pen. Right now, this mass is consisting into it, the amount of matter which is present in this pen. This is not moving anywhere. This pen is not moving anywhere. Here the direction is not specified. That's why the mass is a scalar quantity. It does not change from one place to another. Quantities such as mass and weight are however different. Gram and kilogram are the units of mass. Now normally you should understand the quantities of mass and weight. They are normally different. Okay? How? That we will see further. And gram and kilograms are the units of measuring mass. So keep this in your mind that grams and kilograms are used for measuring the mass. When we use the two pan common balance in the shop, we compare two masses. If you are looking for the balance in a shop, you can see that it consists of two masses. Two mass means they consist of two side dishes present. Now what is meant by weight? Mass and weight both are same, but weight, it is having a direction. Weight is been falling down because gravitational force is acting upon us. Always remember, what is meant by weight? Weight means gravitational force acting on a body is called as weight. So what we measure in grams, kilograms is mass. It is not the weight. The gravitational force that acts on a mass is called its weight. That only I have told you just now. The gravitational force by which the earth attracts an object towards the center is called the weight of an object. For example, if your weight, if I ask, it will be 40 kgs. And why it is 40 kg? Yes, because the gravitational force is acting upon you and it is, you have been pulled down near the earth side. Therefore, weight is a vector quantity. It is different at different places on the earth. Normally you are knowing gravitational force is not the same. That's why weight of a person can vary from different places wherever you go on the earth. We'll see now the next part. Okay, will it be possible to use one and the same unit to measure physical quantities such as mass, weight, distance, velocity and temperature? For example, if I want to measure the milk, if I say give me 2 kilometers of milk, I cannot, if I am going to only use one only unit, for example kilometer, give me 2 kilometers of milk, give me 2 kilometers of potatoes, give me 2 kilometers of cloth. Kilometer is used for measuring the distance. Liter, it is used specifically for measuring the liquid substances. Kgs and grams are used for particularly to measure the solid substance. So this thing we have already decided and they have been specified everywhere. Okay. So in everyday affairs, we measure many different quantities. As these physical quantities are different, so they are having a particular or specific unit. So therefore, different units are used while measuring different quantities. Now, do you know one thing? Our body has weight because of the gravitational force on us. If there was no gravitation on Earth, then our body weight was also not to be defined. The gravitational force of the moon being less, our weight will turn out less over there. If you are knowing, then on moon, the gravitational force is 1/6 of Earth. So your weight will be totally divided by 6, and whatever weight you will get, it will, suppose if my weight is 42 kg, it will be divided by 6, it will be 7 kg on moon. So it depends where you are present. According to that, your weight will change, but mass will not change. Mass will be the same. Your whatever mass which your body consists of, it will be the same. Weight can vary place to place depending upon the gravitational force. Now, standardized measurement. Why standardized measurements are required? Yes. Earlier, when there were big kings, that time, when there was the rule of the kings, there were no standard measurements. There was no measuring machine also. So that time the king was deciding, and whatever measure he used today, that would be the final one. So now we are having the standardized measurement. Few of the standardized measurements, such as you can see over here, there are few systems which are used for measurement. That is MKS system. MKS means mass, KK stands for kilograms, and TS stands for seconds. Here, mass in this system, distance is measured in meters, mass is measured in kilograms, and time is measured in seconds. So that's why distance, which is measured in meters, M is standing for it. Mass, which is measured in kilograms, K stands for it. And time, which is measured in second, S stands for it. In CJS system, C means what? Yes, here it is centimeter. Here distance between two places, it is measured in centimeters. That's why C is coming for that centimeter. G stands for gram. Mass is measured in gram over here, and time, again, it is calculated in second. So M stands for meter, K stands for kilogram, and S stands for time. And in CGS, what it is? C stands for centimeter, G stands for gram, and S stands for seconds. In MKS system of measurement, distance, mass, and time are accepted as fundamental quantities. These quantities are used to measure all other quantities. In MKS system, whatever these three quantities are present, they have been used for measuring all other quantities. Now, for an example, they have given here, a meter M is specified unit for measuring the length. Now, we are using meter for specifying the length. A certain distance has been accepted as the standard for 1.0 meter. Why is there a need for such standard unit? Suppose the span of the hand is accepted as the unit for measuring length. With this unit, we can measure the length of the cloth at 2 hand span, 3 hand span, and so on. Then why is hand span cannot be the standard unit of measuring length? Now, always you remember one thing. Hand span means what? Your hand, the distance, or the distance from your middle finger of your hand and your thumb, that is called to be a span. Now, some people are tall, some people are short. Some people hand, the fingers are long, some are short. So distance or whatever the measuring unit will change according to the hand, according to their size or according to their height. So it will be not a standard one. If you are giving a standard measurement to anyone, it should be the perfect. And that's why these systems came into rule. And that's why these systems were used. So the next part of the lesson we will see further. Okay. Now here they have given you one table, physical quantities in MKS system and in CGS system. Mass, kilogram, and gram they have given over here. Now distance is measured in what in MKS system? Yes, M stands for meter. So meter it will come. And distance in CGS system, what it will come? Yes, it is coming centimeter. Now see for the time. Time, what it will come in MKS system? Yes, it will come. What will time come over here? Yes, time will be in seconds. And again in CGS system, time will be also coming in seconds. Now in MKS system, speed means what? We are knowing speed means what? Distance upon time. We have studied this in 6th standard. So it will be kilometer per hour over here. And in CGS system, what it will be? Meter per second. Okay? So the next part of this lesson we will see later.